2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
Present to you game five of this first round Western Conference matchup. And tonight, it'll be the Memphis Grizzlies going up against the Minnesota Timberwolves. I'm Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge is joining us from the sideline. Hey, Dave.
Hey, Kevin. We have seen D'Angelo Russell's ice in my veins celebration after he makes big shots. And D'Lo credits his father for the inspiration, saying, he used to say that all the time. Play like you have ice in your veins. So that's how I play. No feeling, letting it go, playing free. Kevin, that's how I'm doing the sideline report tonight.
He sure does. Fantastic, David. Thank you. And the starting lineup for the Timberwolves. We've got Malik Beasley. He's out there with D'Angelo Russell. Karl Anthony Towns is out there with Edwards. And it's Vanderbilt in at the four slot. And for the Grizzlies, Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Then there's Ja Morant. Then there's Dylan Brooks. And it's Melton in at the two spot. Tip-off goes to Minnesota. Beasley outside. And there's the pass to Edwards. Nailed from three-point land.
When he's hitting that shot, this offense becomes scary, even more difficult to defend.
Keeps the defense guessing. They don't know who to try to take away.
Now here's Beasley. Towns down low, guarded by Valanciunas. Towns, no luck.
The defense did a really good job of choking off the middle there once he got inside.
Outside Jackson. Morant, right side. Shot clock at five. Brooks against Edwards.
That's a good opportunity, but he needs to go up a little stronger, in my opinion. Can't fault the play call, even though he couldn't convert. That's a good shot.
Now here's Brooks. He's covered closely. Melton feeling it out a bit. Here's Valanciunas, and he finishes nicely on the layup.
Gotta love the big man Valanciunas fighting for that extra chance, and he was rewarded for his effort.
Morant against Russell, and he makes that one.
That's nice work stopping short of the rim, just laying it over the top.
Morant dishes to Jackson. Back to Morant. It's rebounded by Towns.
That was excellent contest, preventing him from making something that's usually automatic.
Here's Edwards. That one's off. He's now one for two. The Grizzlies trail by three. Here's Melton. Morant outside. On the wing, Brooks, covered by Beasley. Here's Jackson, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
The Grizzlies shooting their first free throws here tonight.
Two shots.
And that one falls for Jackson. Jackson hits both of them.
When your bigs can make free throws, it's a huge advantage. Love his approach to getting to the line.
Russell against Morant. Russell passes to Vanderbilt. Count the bucket, and he's got a free throw coming up as well.
In that height, with that much of an advantage height-wise, there's just not a lot the defense can do.
The Timberwolves shooting their first free throw of the evening. And it's Jackson with the ball, bringing it up to the Grizzlies. It's a three-point game. They are pumped right now after a big win on Sunday.
Yeah, facing that hostile crowd, they just found a way to kind of tune out the noise and focus on the game. What was beautiful, it was a tremendous game plan coming in. You saw the execution, and you saw the results.
Coming.
And I'm amazed at Morant's ability to take contact and still stay in full control.
Russell against Morant. Let's it go from 11. Russell, no luck.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Brooks kicks to Morant. Here's Melton. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. Minnesota's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter.
Beautiful location on the pass, as usual. Led his man perfectly.
Morant against Russell. They get it back. Timberwolves leading by three. Edwards dishes to Russell. Lets the three fly. Drains it from beyond the arc. Russell's got five.
Hitting three-pointers, so important in today's NBA. Good thing Russell's got the range and confidence to do so.
There's a lob to Jackson.
Be a nice, silky finish on the alley-oop from the stupendous feed.
That sequence couldn't have been executed any better. Morant against Russell. Vanderbilt kicks it out to Beasley from deep. Again, Minnesota with the triple.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
The Grizzlies trail by seven. Now here's Morant. Here's Valanciunas. Score the basket. His second of two attempts.
Valanciunas has made so many strides as a scorer since he started in the NBA.
Russell passes to Towns. Now Russell. Beyond the arc. Towns. It's good on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Morant surveying the D. And there's the call on Karl Anthony Towns. That's his first foul. Both teams deciding to change it up.
Second team foul. Substitution.
Against Rubio. They get the rebound.
I don't know how many shots he's missed this quarter, but they're going to have to find offense from someone else.
Morant with the steal. It's Allen on the wing. And it's Allen slamming it down.
With the ball in his hands, Ja draws so much defensive attention. Got his teammate a clean look.
Morant against Rubio. To Noel. Here's Reed. Passes to Noel. Just five on the clock. Over Allen. Noel, no good. The Grizzlies trail by five. Now Morant. Pass to Anderson. Feeds it to Clark. Lays it up off the glass.
You gotta know, this is Clark's skill set at this stage of his career. He takes quality shots when he's inside.
Here's Noel. He's still scoreless so far in this one. The shot, no good. And the Grizzlies going the other way now. Allen. And the call on the shot sends him to the line. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Two shots.
The first free throw is good. So he gets them both.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
Noel passes to Hernan Gomez. And here's Rubio. And it's blocked.
Well, where measurements don't tell the whole story. Clark is a tremendous shot blocker despite having an average wingspan.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
And it's a different kind of defense teams play in the postseason. More in your face, physical, high energy plays like that one.
Clock at four. Here's Rubio. Another miss by Minnesota. Memphis trailing here. Nobody near Allen. A miss that time would have put him up. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
Oh, that's not a great foul. For Rubio's career, shoots well over 80% from the line.
This is his first chance at the line tonight. First one falls.
Though he's not known to be a great shooter, Rubio gives you a lot of things. Versatility, size out of the backcourt, and he's a coach out there on the floor.
He hits both from the stripe. And the Grizzlies with possession here. They trail by three. Anderson with the ball. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Now, here is Hernan Gomez. Rubio outside. The pass to Noel. Six on the shot clock. Here's Rubio. That's short off the rim. And Joe Allen will bring it up for Memphis. Here is Anderson. It's hauled in by Noel. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. For Minnesota, they have shot two of three from the free throw line tonight. First free throw is good. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. The Grizzlies trail by five. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Stolen by Rubio. He's just scored his first basket with that shot, making him 1-for-4.
And that whole play starts with Rubio's anticipation. Have to protect the ball around him.
Bane covered by Rubio. He gets that one.
Beautiful call that time up the floor. The hard screen frees him up for the ball.
So the Timberwolves call their first timeout.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, these guys need to work together as a team, as a unit. Try and carve out some easy buckets.
.127 first quarter. The drive by Rubio, and it's denied.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
At the top of the key, Hernan Gomez. Down to five on the shot clock. There's the three. Rubio misses.
Well, so far, this cold night from the field has not affected their ability to maintain this lead.
The Timberwolves working the ball around. Anderson against Hernan Gomez. Pass to Vanderbilt. Here's Noel. No good on the triple.
You know, he might want to think about deferring for a while. He's had his chances this quarter, but just not able to convert.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here's Clark. Oh, that's blocked. From deep, Hernan Gomez. That shot, no good. And we reach the end of the first quarter. Timberwolves lead by five. And we'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. And recently, D'Angelo Russell, Greg, told us about some offseason work he put in.
Yeah, I picked a lot of people's brains. You know, going into the summer, a lot of guys that have made that jump paved the way for us, a lot of older guys. And, you know, the answer that they were giving me was figuring out that routine that your body needs, that your mind needs to prepare for each game. And once I started getting in that consistent routine of napping, eating, my pregame meal, things of that sort, it kind of started to come for me.
Greg doing what he can do to reach that immense potential.
You know, the talent is there. There's never been a question about that, but you also have to be reliable and accountable, both to yourself and to your team. Sounds like that's becoming his focus.
So glad to have you with us here as we bring you more action from courtside at Game 5. And what do you guys think about Minnesota here in this one?
Well, credit their anticipation skills on the defensive end. They forced a number of turnovers.
And you can't cause those mistakes unless you're willing to gamble. So far, they've rolled the dice, and it's paid off.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. On the court, they've got Ricky Rubio, and it's Reed in at the four.
The potential is there. For Clark, it's about expanding the range so that it makes him more versatile offensively.
Grizzlies have hit all four of their chances so far in this one. And And the first one at the line is good. Jaren Jackson, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. De'Anthony Melton comes in for Allen. And so Clark nails both of them. Here's Rubio. Beasley outside. Back to Rubio. He can't get that one. Some solid defense there from Jackson. The Grizzlies trail by three. Quarter number two with just over a minute gone. Anderson trying to free himself up. Jackson misses. The Timberwolves shooting around 29% from the floor. Tough night for them all around on the offensive end.
I think this is Rubio's greatest trait. I love to watch him move the basketball, and so does his coaching staff.
Here's Melton. He's been patient so far. Thing on the and Ricky Rubio the whistle that time. That's foul number two for him. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Valanciunas comes in for Brandon Clark. And Brooks subbed in for Kyle Anderson. Minnesota also with the sub. Russell's checked in. Now here's Jackson. Shot clock at five. Puts one up from 19. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. Towns has got six rebounds here tonight. Here's Beasley. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. And it's 8 points for Beasley.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
And Brooks, here we go. Jackson has the open look. Connects from three-point range.
A player who's aware of everything around him. Brooks sees the man break open and hits him.
Russell from long range. It's rebounded by Memphis. Valanciunas has got six rebounds now in the game. There's the lob to Jackson. Hammers the alley-oop through.
Look at the big man Valanciunas showing off the playmaking skills.
Outside, Towns. From outside, off the mark. The Grizzlies trail by three. Passes it to Melton. There's Valanciunas. He's guarded by Russell. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. That's on D'Angelo Russell.
Being that Valanciunas is 7 feet tall, he is a real problem for the defenses.
The Grizzlies in their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight. The free throw drops for Valanciunas.
They've hit every one of their free throws here in the second quarter. Very important when you're trailing.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Morant's check. And he can't hit the second.
For a player his size, Valanciunas has always been a good free throw shooter. We won't see a heck of Val anytime soon.
Pass to Edwards. Back to Beasley. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jaren Jackson. That is his first foul of the game. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Poked away. Shot clock at six. Beasley kicks to Edwards. From past the arc.
Nice defense by Dylan Brooks, using his power on that play.
Morant against Beasley. Morant outside. From the top of the key. Second chance effort, and Valanciunas puts it in. Valanciunas has got the game tied up here for the Grizzlies.
Hustle points out just like any others. That's a great play.
Towns finds Russell. Now Valanciunas. He's got seven. Morant outside. And here's Brooks. Valanciunas passes to Jackson. Over Edwards, Jackson misses.
Right idea, but just too much heat on him defensively, even with the fadeaway.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. The Timberwolves shooting their sixth and seventh free throw attempts tonight. And he makes the first. And so he hits both. For Memphis, they've gone just 33% from the field in what's been a cold second quarter for them. Just 3 of 9. Here's Morant, and it's good for two.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Minnesota's gotten into trouble with the three ball in the second quarter, only hitting 1 of 5 attempts. It's Smart, and good that time. Russell's got his third basket of the night.
And this is why you like size in the backcourt. Russell taking the hit, yet still able to finish.
Minnesota in the lead. Beasley outside. Here's the three. Rebounded by Jackson. Jackson's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Morant outside. Second shot opportunity and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That one is on Towns. He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
Two shots.
That one falls for Jackson.
And they have that point to get away from them at the line tonight. That's always something that'll allow a coaching staff to breathe a little easier.
And Memphis making a change here. Allen's checked in. Juan Hernan Gomez, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. And so Jackson nails both of them. And the Timberwolves call time.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, these guys need to work together as a team, as a unit. Try and carve out some easy buckets.
Minnesota's gone 1-6 from three-point land in the second quarter. Less than 20%, but they've continued to fly. Hernan Gomez kicks to Russell. Lock at 6. And he uses the glass on the layup. Russell's got 4 points this quarter.
An active competitor, Russell won't go down without a fight, especially around the rim.
Out to Brooks. Shoots the three. They grab their own miss. And the basket by Jackson.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Russell looking around. Grizzlies with the rebound. Memphis with the ball. They're on a 14-6 run. Morant passes to Valanciunas. Good, and a nice assist from Morant. Morant's got 3 assists in the game. And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Trailing by two. Here's Towns. Finds the hole for the second time from the floor. Now 2 for 5.
And I like Russell's ability to create for others. He does what's best for the team.
And the pass to Brooks. Some nice passing there by Memphis. Valanciunas dishes to Morant. Good on the shot. Morant's got the lead up to 2 now for the Grizzlies.
Gotta love watching Morant get after it. He goes all out. Tank never on him.
Russell from long range.
Not sure why he keeps trying his luck from deep here. It's just not his night.
Morant right side. Pass to Valanciunas. From downtown. And it's Morant missing.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
So finds Beasley. Brennan Gomez with the ball. Passes it to Russell. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Russell's got 7 now in this quarter.
Cognizant of the entire court, Russell aware of where the defenders are and really does a great job creating opportunities.
So timeout called here. The first for Memphis.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
So both teams making some changes here. Here's Morant. 6 points for him. Here's Clark. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Easy to appreciate the physicality that Clark plays with. This is what earns him those calls.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
2 shots.
No good on the free throw. That's off as well. So he misses both. Minnesota in the lead. Here's Noel. Minnesota, they have put up good numbers at the charity stripe, converting 6 of 7. And the first one drops.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
So after making the first, he goes 1 for 2. Memphis has gone 1 of 3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Allen for 3. Minnesota with the rebound. Here's Noel. Down low. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
Yeah, an incredible offensive force. Towns showing that strength and touch off. This guy can do it all.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
already a leader at such a young age. Towns' teammates look to him to anchor them on both ends, and he has not disappointed.
To the inside, Anderson, and finished off by Anderson.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. Now, here's Rubio. Just 5 on the clock. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. Fades and shoots. The rebound by Anderson. The Grizzlies trail by 3. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Tough task trying to corral Clark there, especially when he's looking to score.
For Memphis, they have been shooting right around 75% line, 9 of 12 so far.
2 shots.
First free throw is good. And so Clark nails both of them. The Timberwolves shooting about 35% from the floor. Not much falling for them. Pass to Vanderbilt. Boom, he jams it straight down.
You gotta love his aggressiveness to finish inside.
Well, his leaping ability gives him a great advantage. Now, here's Clark. He's got 6. Bain. The shot will not fall. Good D by Rubio. That's a 2 from Towns. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Anderson up top, covered by Rubio. Anderson outside. 6 to shoot. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. And he banks in the layup.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Rubio against Allen. The kick out to Towns. That's in, coming off an assist from Rubio. Towns has got 10 points.
And few seven-footers in the league have Towns' shooting touch. This is a guy you want to create for time and time again.
Now, here's Clark. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
This will make 4 trips to the line so far in the game. And he knocks down the first one. And so Clark nails both of them. And it's Rubio with the ball for the Timberwolves. The pass to Towns. 1 second left. And the last second attempt. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle in this one. But Timberwolves on top, leading by just 2. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Carl, you guys have built a lead. What is the key to maintaining or increasing it going forward?
I mean, don't change what we're doing. So stay together, keep passing the ball, keep playing great defense, and just keep making them think and make decisions, especially the difficult ones.
You had the advantage in the first half. We'll see if you can keep that advantage in the second half. Thanks for your time, man. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Hey again, Ernie Johnson with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. The NBA playoffs are happening, and we're happy to have you here for the halftime show. For the Timberwolves, they've been outplayed this series, currently desperate to keep their season alive, down 3-1. Tonight they're playing definitely with that sense of urgency that they need to, staying right in this game, hoping to force a game six. And Kenny, what did you see out there from the Timberwolves?
The hostile environment in this building has not been an issue. They've come in here, they focused like they would be at home. And it says something about the character of the team. You need to block out the crowd and just play the game.
And over to the big fella. Your thoughts on the Grizzlies' first half?
I like the way they rebounded. They devoted a lot of energy down low, fighting for each other on the boards. And it helped keep this game tight. If they can continue to do that, it could easily be the factor that swings the game in their favor.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
And we're with you again as our round one coverage continues. Nice game, great performance by Jaren Jackson.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
And we're happy to have you back for more playoff basketball here in round one. Jackson and Valanciunas, they're in the middle. Then it's Brooks. Then it's Morant. And it's Melton in at the shooting guard position. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis.
Off the dribble, Morant is so dynamic. Even his teammates look a little stunned.
Here's Russell following the score by Memphis. No good from 18. For the lead, Valanciunas trying to free himself up. And it's Morant missing. Brooks against Edwards. Out to the right wing. Tipped away. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by Jackson. Minnesota making a switch. Vanderbilt's checked in. And that was a great replay we just saw of our mobile one block.
And you've got to take your defense up a notch in the playoffs. He takes it up about three notches on that block.
Five on the clock, deep two from Russell, and that one goes long. Grizzly shooting under 40% all in all for the game. Pass to Melton. And there's the foul, it's on town. And that'll be his third foul so far.
Personal foul. First team foul.
Morant outside. He kicks to Brooks. No luck that time in the shot that would have put them on top. An even three-on-three break. Here's Edwards and the rejection by Valanciunas.
They've come out ice cold to start this half. Three misses and as many attempts.
The Grizzlies with another miss.
Only 1-for-4 in this half. Sometimes it's execution. Sometimes the shots just don't go down.
Grizzlies have gotten just one of their first four shots to fall since coming out of the locker room with the break. Inside, Jackson. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
And this is his third trip to the line tonight.
Two shots.
And that they now lead by one. The Timberwolves making a switch here. Reed's checked in. and good on the second, so he makes them both. And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now. Morant against Russell. Kicks it to Towns. Trying to end the drought. And the layup is good. Towns has got it all tied up now for the Timberwolves.
And you see Big Cat that has the size and coordination. Hard to bump him out of his rhythm.
Right side Jackson. Dish now to Brooks. Shot clock at six. Out to Morant. Lets it go from deep. That one doesn't drop.
Very cold start to the second half. 1 for 5, looking for some continuity. You know, we talk a lot about scoring efficiency. He's displaying the exact opposite. Unusual for him, just a lack of concentration. Fails to finish the play.
Yeah, a nice, strong finish on the inside.
But Greg, that's what he does. He's got the dunker mentality. Now, here's Valanciunas. He's got 9. And play stops. Whistle on what looks to be an illegal steal.
And guys, point of emphasis for the league is to really crack down on illegal screens.
Yes, the last few years, the rules changes have tended to benefit the offenses. This evens things out a bit.
Russell against Morant. Offensive rebound. And the rejection by Jackson. And so it looks like the Timberwolves will retain possession here. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Just 5 to shoot. They get a hand on it, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Ja Morant. That'll be his second foul of the game. Memphis on defense. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. Timberwolves passing it around. Clock at 6. Russell from long range.
He had 6 points from long range in the first half, but nothing's fallen here since.
Brooks kicks to Morant. Makes it off the glass. Morant's got 4 points in the quarter.
Hard trying to contain Morant. When he makes up his mind, he's going to score. He goes for a four.
Jackson against Russell. This is it to Reed. Over Morant. Reed misses. And Morant's got the ball here for Memphis. That one good for 2.
Well, Morant's awareness in the pick and roll is special. He usually makes the right reads.
And the Timberwolves call time here.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, these guys need to work together as a team, as a unit. Try and carve out some easy buckets.
Anderson, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. The Timberwolves also with the sub. Rubio's checked in. Timberwolves trail. Pass to Towns. Over Valanciunas. Towns, no luck. The Grizzlies have gone 3 of 8 so far in the third quarter, looking to lock in that rhythm. Anderson in the post. Edwards there. Here's Valanciunas. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Valanciunas has got the lead up to 4 now for Memphis. Morant against Rubio. And the pass to Beasley. From about 19 feet. And Valanciunas pulls it down. Alan Giannis has got rebound number 19 now. Incredible board work.
And it's still a rare sight to see rebound numbers like the ones he's had tonight.
It's incredible. And I'll tell you what, it's a joy to watch. There's more to his game than threes and dunks.
Here's Morant. Anthony Edwards making his last shot. Pass to Valanciunas. Back to Morant. And he gets the bucket.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Vanderbilt's checked in, and it's Juan Hernan Gomez in for Edwards.
How can you not love a player like Ja Morant? Came into the NBA ready to prove himself and just keeps getting better.
Now, here's Rubio. The shot, no good. Morant with some nice D. The three buries the long-range jumper. Morant's got 12 points here in the second half.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Here's the thing. He's a guy who will go on hot streaks for you over a number of games.
And wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
But look at the basket guy still shaking.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Pass to Noel. Pass to Reed. And the rejection by Valanciunas.
You see the length of Valanciunas on display with that block. Just went up and got it.
Well, I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
For Minnesota, they have shot 8 of 10 from the line. That's an even 80% free throw shooting here. First one falls for him. And so he makes both from the line. And so it's Memphis with it. 6-point lead. Up there for Clark.
Oh, can we get a load of that one? Take that play and put it in the alley-oop textbook, boy.
Oh, perfectly done. You're right. He put it on a platter for him. Rubio outside. There's the pass to Reed. Here's Noel. 5 to shoot. On deep. The rebound by Anderson.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
And all second half, they haven't gotten stops with any consistency.
Now, here's Rubio. From deep three-point range, it's rebounded by Memphis. Clark's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Here's Allen. Clark trying to get open. Allen's shot is off. Timberwolves trail by 10. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Rubio looking it over. Reed gets the bucket.
Excellent setup. Rubio scopes out the weakness in the defense, then exploits it.
Rubio against Allen. The pass to Clark. And the layup's good off the glass. Clark's got 14 points for the game.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Against him. And he gets the whistle. whistle. Two free throws coming up. The Timberwolves have been getting it done at the line. 10 for 12. The first one falls, and Memphis making a change here. Elton's checked in. Edwards, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. And he makes both free throws.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
And the Grizzlies leading by eight. And it's blocked. It away. And here we go. The Grizzlies on a fast break. Melton's shot is good.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Timberwolves trail by 10. Pass to Vanderbilt. There's the steal. Now on the bounce pass. 12 feet out. It's hauled in by Noel.
Well, this is where he's inconsistent, and that can slow down your team's momentum.
Rubio outside, fires from the wing, misses off the right iron.
They keep calling his number, which is partly how they've dug this hole.
Allen with it, to the middle. No good from Clark. 43 seconds left to play in the third. Here's Edwards. It's rebounded by Memphis. Anderson passes to Allen. Passes it to Tillman. Now Clark takes the bucket. Now he's got 5 field goals, 5 for 8 in the game.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Pass to Reed, and he dunks it down.
And in terms of size, not your typical center, but, man, he plays as big as any of them thanks to that terrific leaping ability.
And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Grizzlies lead by 10. Live from the FedEx Forum, you're watching 2K Sports. Thanks for joining us as we get back to the action on the court. And it's Russell with the ball. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. And a look at the 5 for the Timberwolves to start the 4th. They've got Edwards. Towns is out there with Russell. And it's Noel in at the 2.
Already one of the league's more creative assist men. Russell making people around him better.
Brooks misses.
A for effort, but when there's that much resistance at the rim, better find another option.
One is off. Malik Beasley, he's checked in for Minnesota. No good on the second free throw. And the Grizzlies leading by 8. Brooks feeling it out a bit. The pass to Melton. 5 on the clock. 3-pointer. A rebound by the Timberwolves. Edwards got 4 rebounds in this game.
You know what? They're winning, though, despite the fact that he has just been really off.
Pass to Towns. Three-pointer. It's Clark with the rebound.
Hasn't been able to dial it in from distance. He has just the 1-3, and that was in the first half.
Here's Anderson, and Anderson slams it in.
On the drive, Anderson won't blow by you, but he'll find a way to get his shot.
Russell kicks to Edwards. Here's Towns. It's Clark with the rebound. Clark's got 7 rebounds in the game.
Solid rebound there, and with the score like it is, that's an area where they can't afford to get lazy.
At the line for the Grizzlies. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
Some changes for Memphis. Jaren Jackson, he's checked in for Brandon Clark. And it's John Morant in for Kyle Anderson. Both good from the line that time. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Here's Russell, and he gets it to go from the high post.
And something Russell did well in college, scoring off the pick and roll.
Rand, oh, the power on that throwdown.
As creative as they come, Ja Morant has a style that's specifically his.
Russell passes to Towns. Passes to Edwards. Over Brooks. Edwards can't hit.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Here's Melton. He can't hit that time. Nice D from Russell. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead has cut down now to just 10 on the basket from Edwards.
Any chance you get, you want to put yourself in a position to succeed, and that's what he did there.
Great job of reading the floor, got to the rim, and made a play.
And the first one drops. So he picks up just 1 from the line that time. And down it goes. Dunk threw off a wonderful assist.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
It's Morant with the drive.
With the ball on the string, John Morant is toying with the defense. Beautiful.
And the Timberwolves call timeout.
Yeah, just looking to tighten up their defense in the paint. They've got to be better.
It's a matter of want to. Helping out, contesting shots. You have to want to make the effort.
Valanciunas, who's checked in for Memphis. Now let's go. go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, I was able to listen in on the Timberwolves head coach talking to his team. He is not pleased, and he told them they have to make a push right now. He said, look, we got to make a move, or I've got to pull the plug. I did one stuff, Kevin. Back to you.
And he just dangles from the bucket after sending that one through.
And you can see which team has the swagger right now. Here's Russell. Pass to Vanderbilt. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Vanderbilt's got 4 points this quarter.
And 10 of their last 12 coming off assists.
And Jackson throws it down hard.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. And they call an illegal screen here.
That's just his first turnover of the night. What a steady, efficient game he's played thus far. And he has to take that long, slow walk back to the bench here. He'll watch the rest of this one from the sideline.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Reeves checked in.
And after a first half in which their offense shot under 40%, they've got the lead, and they should count themselves to be lucky.
Morant against Russell, and he gets it to go.
And look at Russell bringing the intensity. He's stronger now, willing to mix it up inside no matter who's on it.
And the dunk by Jackson.
And that dunk reverberated throughout this entire building.
It sure did. Up high and down hard on the windmill flight. Pass to Russell. Back to Beasley. And it's Beasley finishing it off.
And once he gets clear off the screen, there is no stopping him.
No, not when there's a flush waiting to happen.
That's a big-time move and a big-time finish.
And it's Brooks in the corner. Good, and a nice assist from Morant. Morant's got assist number 7 for him tonight.
A big-time ISO player in college. Brooks has shown the ability to play off the ball at this level.
Beasley, the pass to Reed. Here's Russell, and again it's Minnesota.
I will say this about his shooting stroke. It's pure when he's got it going. Perfect so far this quarter.
Timeout called, the Grizzlies.
And Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes a timeout like this allows you to kind of just reset.
Let's present our New Balance player of the game, Ja Morant.
And Kevin, it's a no-brainer. He's controlled every aspect of this game, and it's just so fun to see a player perform at a level that's just higher than anyone else out on the floor.
And he'll head into the second round with his confidence at its highest level. He couldn't have picked a better time to take his game up a notch. Kicks it to Jackson. Beasley with the rebound. Timberwolves trail by 12. Here's Edwards. Rebounded by Jackson. Jackson's got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Morant passes to Melton. The pass to Brooks. And the call is going to be, yes, it is, an illegal screen.
And not the most common call you'll see in the NBA, but hard to argue that pick wasn't illegal. It's often a tough call that can go either way, but I agree with you on that one.
Reed the pass to Beasley. gets it to drop, and now he's shooting at a 5-for-8 clip.
Talented, driven. He puts constant pressure on your defense.
Morant passes to Jackson. That one, no good. Timberwolves trail by 10. Here's Beasley. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. And he makes the first. And Beasley drops both of them. And here's Morant. He'll bring it up for the Memphis Grizzlies. They've led by as many as 14 points. And that one drops. Morant's got 28.
What a night for John Morant, showing off that versatility, and he's relentless at the offensive end.
Here's Russell. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. That one's on Morant. First free throw is good.
Being a lottery pick often comes with high expectations, but Russell has shaped into a quality NBA player.
Anderson, he's checked in for Memphis. And so Russell hits them both. And the Grizzlies leading by 8. Morant outside. Brooks outside. Here's Melton. And it's off from three-point range. Pass to Edwards. Can't hit that one. Nice D from Brooks. And they double up Morant. Melton's shot is good.
After a lackluster first half, he's taken charge offensively. We'll see how the defense responds.
Passes it to Reed. Takes a three. Timberwolves with a fresh shot clock. Great positioning on the putback.
Oh, great timing. He is one tough customer on that offensive glass.
You know, it's like he has a sixth sense of where that rebound is going. A floater, and Morant finishes inside. Morant's got 10 points now just in this quarter.
These are big buckets. He's been instrumental in helping them try to close out this game.
That one's good, and the Grizzly lead is cut to just 9 points on the basket from Russell.
Taking things into his own hands this quarter, trying to keep his team afloat.
Morant passes to Valanciunas. Pass to Melton. And here's Brooks from outside. Offensive rebound. And it's Valanciunas finishing it off.
When you have the size that Valanciunas has, there aren't many people getting in the way of your dunk.
Here's Russell, and the slam dunk by Russell.
And that's a special play coming from the one spot.
You know, his passing can take a backseat for that dunk. Wow.
It just shows you the versatility. This guy can do a lot of different things for you. Woo-hoo. He knew what he wanted to do all along. The teardrop.
Outside, Russell. No good on the three. To the paint, and that one is hammered home.
Good athlete, 37-inch vertical. Brooks aggressive above the rim.
Now, here is Russell. And it's Beasley in the corner. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist.
I like what he's doing here. Terrific efficiency scoring the basketball.
And guys, just really impressed. They made big plays when it counted, and that's why it's going to be on to the next round for the Grizzlies.
They never settled for mediocre shots.
And Kevin, they had great penetration. this time out.
And a great team effort tonight, helped in large part with contributions and the nice night it ended up being for Ja Morant.
Shouldering the load for them all night offensively. He came in focused, ready to go, and he delivered.
Kept alive. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's on Anthony Edwards.
Love the aggression that Valanciunas showed there. He welcomed the contact inside to get to the line.
Two shots.
The free throw drops for Valanciunas, so it's both teams making substitutions here. Valanciunas hits them both. 30 seconds left in the game. Bounce pass, Rubio. And again, Minnesota with the triple.
He goes to the bounce pass there. Nice rhythm at the end of the play.
And they can just let the clock run out here.
Cannot argue with the W.
Jones against Rubio. Now Jones. And they're going to move on to the conference semifinal. They had control the whole series, and they are just rolling now, winning round one, 4-1.
And they are going to be tough to beat, Kevin. A few days rest afforded by taking this one in 5. Round 2 should be exciting as well.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Jonas, you have a lot on you in terms of patrolling the paint. How do you think you're doing?
I feel good. You know, there is a better game, there is a worse game, but, you know, I'm bringing energy every game. I'm fighting, and my job is to take rebounds, set a screen. I'm doing that job.
It's grunt work, but you're good at it. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that about wraps it up, folks. We hope you've enjoyed our broadcast of the NBA Western Conference Quarterfinals. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.